Looking forward and focusing on the positive can be key when it comes to managing a serious health issue. So let's meet a woman who says she believes in the expression, making lemonade out of lemons, when it comes to her chronic illness. Joint dislocations have been a part of Diana Prangy's life since childhood.
As I was growing, I had multiple repeated dislocations of lots of body parts. And it finally got to the point where this shoulder was just like, it would hang out of the socket.
Pain and digestive issues soon followed, but it wasn't until she reached adulthood that her doctors began to put the pieces together and decided to test her for hypermobility.
One of the things that we test them on is a thing called the Bighton score. Hypermobile joints tend to be the pinky finger, it's the thumb, the elbow, the knees, and being able to bend over forward and touch the floor. Full palms.
So there's 9 different parts to determine if I could go past what's considered normal. And I was like a 7 out of 9.
Diana was diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome.
Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome is a group of connective tissue disorders. There's actually 13 different types. But the 3 things that all of the Ehlers-Danlos have in common, one is hypermobile joints. The second thing is called tissue fragility. And what that means is that their tissue can tear easily, it scars easily. And then the last part of it is they have hyperextensible skin. And the hyperextensible skin means that their skin can stretch further than what, again, the normal population.
I felt validation because for my whole life, it's like I knew something inside me wasn't right. My doctors advised that what we have to do is provide support to keep my symptoms to a minimum so that I can have the best quality of life.
And that started with physical therapy and specialized exercises.
Physical therapy helps tremendously because it helps them to kind of strengthen the tissues and the muscles around the joints that are giving the most problem.
Diana was also fitted with special braces to give her joints extra support when she needs it.
So that these muscles don't have to fight so hard, and so that's really helped a lot. I get a lot less pain.
She also uses medication and ice to bring her relief, and says sometimes it's just about giving her body a rest.
I have the tools when I'm having a bad day, where I'm having a lot of pain, I know things that I can do to help so that the next day will be better.
If you give people the tools, it does empower them to be able to help alleviate their own symptoms.
Diana says the final piece of the puzzle for her was embracing what she can still do and finding joy in those activities.
I try to see like the lemonade and the lemons. I don't have control over the way that I was made, but I can control my attitude about it.
Diana now hopes to inspire others living with Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome to stay strong through the symptoms.
The challenge is adjusting to the new normal, you know, and then finding a way to make the new normal work for you.
If you start to worry about that, that's where you need to go to a provider that can diagnose it properly. If you are having these symptoms, to not get discouraged and to not worry about, you know, oh, nobody believes me. There are places that you can go to and get the appropriate information.
To learn more about EDS, head to the Ehlers-Danlos Society website, Ehlers-Danlos.com.